Okay, if you've started App Inventor with the Paint Pot Media Only template, this is what you should see when you open that project. You should see that there's the kitty.png image in the media drawer. There are no components on our interface yet, and our blocks editor has no blocks in it. Before we start building the app, let's save the project as a new name. I'm going to name mine Paint Pot 1, because there is going to be a part 2 to this app. So I've renamed it, and App Inventor is opening up the new project. First thing we want to do for our app is put together the user interface. And if you remember from the preview, our user interface is going to consist of an image of the cat on a canvas in the middle of the screen, three buttons, a red, a blue, and a green above it, and a fourth button, wipe, that will clear the screen below it. So let's put that together. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to pull out a horizontal arrangement from my layout drawer, and then I'm going to put three buttons into that. One, two, and three. Then for each button, we want to change its text and its color, its background color, so that it matches the color that it's going to change the paint to. So let's choose button one, and I'm going to make the text on that button say red. And I'm going to change its background color to red. Okay? So I'm going to pause here for a moment and let you do that task for the other two buttons. When you're done, the button in the middle should say blue and be blue, and the button on the right should say green and be green. Okay, now that you've finished that task, this is how your user interface should look. The next thing we want to do is give our buttons more meaningful names. The reason for this is so that when we go over to the blocks editor, we'll be able to tell that button 1 really is the red button, and button 2 are the blue, and button 3 the green. To rename a button, you click on it in the components panel, and you click the rename button and give it a new name. So I'm going to name the first button red, and now its name will be red. And when we go over to the blocks editor, it'll be easy to tell that that's the button we want to use when we want to change the color to red. So I'm going to pause again here and let you rename the other two buttons, all three buttons actually, to red, blue, and green. Okay, good. Now our buttons are named button red, button blue, button green. The next task is to change the layout of the buttons so that they fill the horizontal space at the top of the screen. In order to do that, we first need to change the width of the horizontal arrangement component so that it fills its parent. As you can now see, it spans the entire width of the screen. To change the button's width, we click on the button and we change its width property to fill parent. And now notice that it's taking up as much space as it can inside the horizontal arrangement. So I'm going to pause here and let you change the width to fill parent for the other two buttons, and so that when you're done, all three will have the same spacing. Okay, so this is what our user interface should look like now. Our next task is to add the canvas component, which is in the drawing and animation drawer, and I'm going to add it just below the buttons. And I'm going to change its width so that it fills its parent. And I'm going to set its background image to the kitty.png file that we've already loaded into the project. The last thing we need to do is put a fourth button, call it the wipe button. So I'm going to rename this to button wipe. And this is the button that we'll click when we want to clear the screen. Okay, now that we have our user interface complete, this would be a good time to connect to our device. So I'm going to go up here, I'm going to say connect to the AI companion, and I'm going to pull up my device and select the companion app on it, scan that barcode, there we go. Tapping the buttons, of course, does nothing because we haven't programmed them. Before we move to the blocks editor, I'd like you to think about one thing. How many event handlers are we going to need for this app? If you recall, in the I Have a Dream app, we had two buttons, and so we needed two event handlers, one for each button. And for this app, In addition to our several buttons, we have some drawing events. So think about that for a moment. Think about what we're trying to do and try to come up with a guess for how many event handlers we're going to need. If you said six, you're right. We need one for each of the four buttons, plus we have two types of drawing events. One is going to be to draw dots, and the other is going to be to draw lines. So that makes six altogether. So let's switch over to the blocks editor now, which is blank. And let's first work on the red button. So I'm going to pull out the when button red click. Now what I want to do when this button is clicked is I want to set the paint color on the canvas to red. So I'm going to go into my canvas drawer, and I'm going to pull out what's called the setter block. There's a whole bunch of them there. These are these dark green blocks. What I want to set is the paint color. So I'm going to pull this setter block out, plug it into my event handler. But I want to also show you that any setter block would have sufficed, because we can use this pull-down menu here to change the property that's being set in any of the setter blocks. But we want to set the paint color, and we want to set it to the value red. So I'm going to go in my colors drawer, pull out the red block, plug it in here. So what this is doing is it's saying set the paint color property of the canvas to red. That action alone isn't going to be visible on our screen until we actually paint a dot on the screen. So let's go back into our canvas, and when the canvas is touched, that's this block here, that's the event handler we want to draw a dot. So what we need is we need a drawing block from the canvas drawer, and in fact the second purple block is a block for drawing a circle. Now notice that our when canvas touch block has three properties that it can provide us. It can provide us the X and the Y coordinate, where the screen was touched, and a touch sprite. Our app isn't using sprites, so that third property is one we can just ignore for now. And when we draw our dot or our circle, we want to draw it right at the spot where the canvas was touched. So I'm going to go in here and get the X value of where this canvas was touched and the Y value, and simply plug them into the XY coordinates for where we want the circle drawn. And the last value we have to set when we draw a circle is the actual radius of the circle. And so I'm going to go into my math drawer and pull out a number. And let's just pull out and use the number 5 for the size of our circle. Okay? So now with these two blocks combined, if we go back to our app on our device and touch it, we should see a dot. There we go. So we see a black dot because we haven't yet set the color to red. So I'm going to tap the red button and now draw a dot, and I see a red dot. And every time I touch the screen, I'll see a red dot. I'm going to pause here and let you complete the coding of the blue and the green buttons. Okay, so to perform these tasks, you merely have to copy and paste the button red dot click and change the name of it for each respective button, blue and green, and change the colors that you're setting the paint color to. So now when I tap the blue button and touch canvas, I get a blue dot. When I tap the green button, I get a green dot. The next task for our app is to get it to draw lines. So let's go back into our canvas. Notice that we have a purple block for drawing a line, and it takes two sets of parameters, the X and Y coordinates of where you start the line and the X and Y coordinates of where you end the line. Now, what we want is we want to handle a canvas drag event. So let's go back in there. Here's the block for dragging, because when we drag our finger across this canvas, we want it to draw a line from where we started until the end. Notice that you have quite a few properties on the dragged event. Starting values for X and Y, the previous values for X and Y, and the current values for X and Y. Now you might think that what we want in X1 and Y1 are the starting values, but that's not right. So let's try that actually, and we'll see that it doesn't quite give us the behavior we want. We want the current values of X and Y to be where we draw the line to, so let's put those values in for X2. F2 and Y2. And then let's give this a try on our device. Now when I go back here, if I drag across the screen, you can see that it's not really giving me what I want. And the reason is that it's drawing repeatedly every time I move from where I started when I first touched the screen to where I currently am. So what I really want to do is I want to change this to the previous value of X and the previous value of Y. And then what happens is that I'm going to draw a line now from my starting point to my end point, and you'll see that it draws a single line. The way the dragged event handler works is it's repeatedly sending us our previous and our current point, as well as remembering the starting point. But we want to draw, in every case, from the previous to the current, and that's what gets it to draw lines and circles and all other kinds of shapes. And finally, the last thing we need to do is we need to take care of our wipe button so that we can rewipe our screen. So I'm going to go back in and I'm going to take the button wipe. I'm going to get its event handler out. And then I want to look in my canvas drawer for something that will clear the screen. And indeed, we have a purple block here that will clear the screen. But the other thing I need to do is I need to go back to my designer and change the name, the text on that button to say wipe. Okay, so let's test our app now. Let's draw some blue dots. Let's draw a blue smile. Let's outline the eyes in red sunglasses. That gives us a nice picture of the cat. Now let's wipe the screen. There, and that completes our first version of the PaintPot app.